Hi guys, it is Christy K, and I'm here to compare my NYX Angelville to my Hourglass Mineral Foundation. Now, they do have a really similar finish, and people are saying that they're dupes, so I'm actually going to try and test them out. I'm going to an event right now, so I feel like this is the perfect time. This one retails for like $16. This one, I want to say, is like $56, but this isn't the full size. This is the baby one that's like $19, but this is like 1 ounce, and this is 0.30 ounces. So if I can spend $15 and get the same finish, I'm all for it, because $19 and I don't even have half of what's in there, it's just not worth my time. And if I can also avoid spending $56 for the full size, I'm all for it. So I'm going to take the NYX Angelville and I'm going to put it on my left side, and I'm going to take Hourglass and put it on my right. And after that, I'm going to do my full foundation, and I'm going to come back and let you see how it settles and finishes. And then I'm going to go to my event. I'm going to be gone for a few hours, and then I'm going to come back, and that's going to be the real test to see how it holds up while I'm out in at an event. So let's get started. Starting first with the Hourglass. Expensive. I'm going to take 2 pumps and just rub it in. So they both have like a white finish, and they kind of feel like a little powdery. I probably put too much. Oh, Lord. Okay, I only got one nose, so we're going Hourglass this whole nose. I'm not trying to half and half the nose. Oh, do you see that I rubbed my eyebrow off? Good Lord. You know it. Alright, now we're going to NYX the other side. So this formula is thicker, but it still has like the powdery finish to it. And it's also not mineral like the other one. See if I can keep my eyebrow on this side. Like, y'all, Dip Brown let me down because it definitely rubbed off my eyebrow. For foundation today, what is my choice going to be? I'm going to take the Lancome. This Lancome. And see what it do. This one is a little darker than me, so I have a shade that's like in between this to balance out those tones. This is a little bit too light, a little bit too dark, so it gives me like my perfect tone since I'll be changing the colors. Blend this joint out. I hope I don't forget to put my eyebrow back on, but as far as right now, I can't tell the difference. The finish looks the same, but like the real test is really how it wears on all your makeup. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to finish my face, and I'm going to come back, and we're going to see how it sits and settles once I apply like my concealers, my powders, my blushes. So I will be back shortly. So now I am back with the full beat, and this is the NYX side right here. Looks good to me, like everything set well, it looks nice. And this is the Hourglass side, like literally still at this point I cannot tell a difference. So it's 204 right now, and everything looks good, but I'm gonna check back in maybe in like 4 or 5 hours after I get home from the event, after I'm out, and see what starts to happen, see what settles in my fine lines. Like, I have smile lines now, so like just see how everything works out. So I will see you guys in a little bit. Okay guys, so I'm following back up with you guys. It is 1:33. I so meant to get home earlier, but life happens. And this side is the NYX side. This is the Hourglass side. So I literally had like a full day in some. So it's the NYX side here. Hourglass side. But as I'm looking in the mirror and looking closer, one, to the naked eye, you can't tell that I have my 2 primers. I do get a little oily and a little shiny, and my highlighter doesn't necessarily help me. It kind of makes things a little bit worse. Like, honestly, I like to put highlighter right here, and I know I shouldn't, but like right here, like if I didn't have highlighter right here, I feel like it wouldn't look so oily. But I feel like actually the NYX side might be the winner. I'm getting like smile lines, but I feel like they're more prominent over here on the Hourglass side. And I just also feel like the finish of my skin on this NYX side looks better. And this looks okay, but like when I'm looking, I'm doing the, I feel like this looks better. Even my nose is really oily. And because I only have one nose, like we all do. I use the hourglass only for my nose, but it's really like oily, and I feel like the foundation and stuff is broken up. And I would get this right here because it got the job done. Now keep in mind that I have oily combination skin. Just because it's worked well for me like this doesn't mean it's gonna work exactly the same way for you, so please keep that in mind. But yeah, right now I'm a little dry, and with me and all my dryness, this is how this worked and this is how it's set. Okay, so that's pretty much it, you guys. I feel like NYX is the winner. And if you don't want to spend a lot of money, go NYX, spend $16 and definitely save your money. It's definitely, definitely. So just an FYI, people don't like to go home. I still have people at my house, and even though they're not in my room, I can hear the full conversation. So you might be able to hear it too. So if you can, I'm sorry. Sorry. That's all I have for you guys. If you guys like this video or videos like this, or you want to see more like comparisons, give me a thumbs up. If you have any ideas of what I should compare, comment down below. Let me know. And thank you guys so much for watching. I appreciate you guys so much. I will see you in my next video. Mwah.